This diagram is visible everyone clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we will discuss one by one. Okay. So this is the mouth part. Okay. So it is what we are going to understand, the physiology of physiology of human digestive system. Okay. Okay. So this is the mouth part from where the food is, you know, intaking by the human being. It contains the buccal cavity. In buccal cavity, teeth and tongue is present. So this is all about all the digestive glands which are present and their functions and their location. Okay. So here we have salivary gland. Okay. It produces the salivary amylase. It contains salivary amylase will help in digestion of carbohydrate. Then this is the tongue. What is the role of tongue? Anyone?
To taste the food.
Okay, to taste the food. To taste the food. Okay. This is the first. Yes. Second.
It helps to move the food around.
Yes. It helps to assist the food during mastication. To assist the food during mastication. Okay. Tongue is only responsible whatever the food which is not masticated, that food is, you know, pushed by the tongue between the teeth, okay, in order to crush the food. Okay, so that's why we have written here to assist the food during the mastication process. Okay, so these are the two important functions of the tongue. Okay, then we have esophagus. This is part is called as esophagus. Okay, so esophagus, here the bolus food enters and which passes through the esophagus to the stomach by the peristalsis movement. Peristaltic movement. Okay, and from here food is passes through the stomach finally. Okay, so this is the stomach part. So stomach, it pummels the food, means it churns the food by the, you know, muscular contraction and relaxation of the muscle, okay, with the muscular wall. Okay, during the contraction and relaxation of the muscular wall of the stomach, which, you know, pummels the food. Pummels the food means churning of the food. Churning of okay. Second role, to produce the protease enzyme, okay, which helps in digestion of protein. Helps in digestion of protein. Okay. Third, it produces hydrochloric acid. It due to the two reasons. See, first one, to kill the microorganism like bacteria and harmful pathogens, or we can say disease causing pathogens, and to give the right pH for the protease enzyme in order to work. Okay, that means we can say in acidic medium, protease enzyme get activated in digestion of the protein. Okay, so HCl increases the activity of digestive enzyme. Okay. So this is again the very important part. Understood? we have already been discussed. That's why we are, you know, moving very fast to complete our session within given period. Yes, beta.
Yes, sir. Udbhav is in waiting room, sir.
Udbhav and Anudeep. Udhav, Anudeep, what's wrong, beta?
Sir, power question.
Okay, so this is the stomach part. Okay, now next part we are going to discuss about the sphincter muscles. Okay, so sphincter muscles are ring-like. Okay, sphincter muscles are ring-like and they present around the opening of the stomach into the small intestine, where, you know, when food is being entered from stomach to small intestine, they relax. The sphincter muscle get relaxed automatically. Okay, and when there is no entering of the food from stomach to small intestine, then they contract. Okay, so during contraction, this path get closed, and during relaxation, this path get open. Okay, so we can say this ring muscles, which, you know, regulates the entering of the food from stomach to the small intestine, okay, which are the squeeze shut mouth most of the time. Okay, say whenever the food is going to enter from stomach to small intestine, they get relaxed and they opens the path, and the food is entered from stomach to the small intestine. Okay, beta. This is the main role of sphincter muscles. I'm going to write the role here. This is the sphincter muscle I'm writing here. Okay, it regulates. It regulates the entering of. It regulates the, yes, entering of food from stomach to small intestine. I'm writing only INT means intestine. No? So you have to write full form of the intestine, not INT only. Okay, then we have next part is liver. Okay, so liver, the main role is to secrete the bile juice. Okay, and bile juice helps to emulsify the fat. That means it contains the fat digest, the enzyme which is going to digest the fat. And what is the name of that enzyme? Called lipase. Okay, so bile juice contain lipase enzyme, which helps in digestion of the fat. Okay, to make the condition rigid for the enzyme in the small intestine, and it makes the food alkaline. Okay, and in alkaline medium, that lipase becomes more active in order to digest the fat. Okay, then we have gallbladder. So gallbladder is the, you know, like pouch-like structure which is present near the liver in order to store the bile juice secreted by the liver. Okay, so gallbladder, where the bile juice is being stored before it is injected into the small intestine. Okay, so this part is called as gallbladder. See here, this is the gallbladder. Okay, then after gallbladder we have pancreas. Okay, so pancreas produces three type of important enzyme. One is protease, which helps in digestion of protein. These are of two types, okay? Trypsin and chymotrypsin. We already been discussed in last part of that video, okay? Then it also secretes enzyme which helps in digestion of carbohydrate, and it also secretes lipase also. So it should not be carbohydrate, it should be amylase. Okay, so amylase helps in digestion of carbohydrate. Okay, so pancreas secretes protease in the form of trypsin. Protease in the form of trypsin and chymotrypsin. We have already been discussed in last part of the last diagram, is it? And it also secretes lipase, which helps in digestion of fat. Okay, then next part is the small intestine. Okay, so small intestine produces all the three enzymes, which are protease. Then it should not be carbohydrate, it should be amylase. Okay, and lipase. This is also where the food is absorbed into the blood, okay, with the help of villi and microvilli. See, here we have written villi. See, villi, they absorb the nutrition, and that nutrition get mixed into the blood, okay? And the process of after completion of the absorption process, then food enters into the large intestine, okay? The inner surface of the, you know, small intestine covered with the finger-like projection called villi. So villi are the important for the absorption of food. So what is the main role of villi? To absorb nutrition from food. Okay. And which increases the surface area. Okay. If, see, they present like in this structure. Okay. So they, due to this structure, they provide large surface area for the absorption of food. Okay. It is also, okay, a very long. Okay. That's why they are like finger-like projection. Okay. And on the finger-like projection, microvilli are also present at the surface region. Okay. This also helps in digestion of food. Okay. So this is the villi. And these are the microvilli. Okay, we will discuss in detail about the villi also in next lecture. Don't worry. Okay, then we have large intestine. So large intestine is, you know, very important for the absorption of water and salt. Okay, here only water is given, but their absorption of water along with salt. Okay, due to the salt very important to produce electrolytes. So we can say absorption of water along with electrolytes takes place in large intestine. Okay. And in large intestine, no digestion process takes place. Okay. After large intestine, we have the last part is called as the rectum, where the fecus are stored. Fecus is nothing but the residue of the digested food and undigested food, which is stored in the rectum. And it is temporarily stored there. Okay, then it is defecated out from the body. Okay, it is removed out from the body by the process called defecation. Okay, through the anus. Okay, so this is all about the physiology of the human digestive system. Understood, Veda?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so again, I want you to take a screenshot for that. Wait a second, let me zoom in a little. Yep. Now take a screenshot. Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I hope you all have understood this the physiology of the digestive system very well. Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Any more doubt, Bida? No?
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir.
Okay. So, have you enjoyed the session?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Have you taken the screenshot for this diagram also?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So no doubt in both the diagrams?
No doubt, sir.
So in next lecture, in 20 minutes, we will, you know, going to cover the question answer session. Okay? Tomorrow. So I want you all to go through this both of the diagram and whatever we have completed. Okay? So we will have the oral section tomorrow. In 20 minute session, we will cover the oral answer, question answer. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, sir, about this only, sir?
Yes. Means the human nutrition system.
Okay, sir.
Okay, nutrition in human being. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So we are going to complete our session here only. Okay, beta? So probably we will have lecture tomorrow also. Okay. Yeah. So bye. Everyone, see you in the next lecture.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Bye.